Hey everybody, today I want to talk to you about cable management. When we start doing astrophotography with our telescope, one of the first things that we do is we start replacing eyepieces with cameras. And with those cameras come cables. And those cables have to go somewhere. And most of the time when we're starting out, those cables just dangle off the back of the telescope and connect into a laptop somewhere. And over the career of our astrophotography, we start to accumulate more accessories to make our lives a little easier. And so what I'd like to show you now are all of the things that I have accumulated over the last 4 years of attempting astrophotography and illustrate the problem that cable management has become as I've grown from trying to take my first photos of the moon to getting into some of the more long exposure photography. The first thing that we're going to use with our astrophotography, obviously, is a camera. And here I've got my ASI 174 mono camera from ZWO. And this just screws right into the back of the telescope. We're all familiar with how that works. One USB port, one USB cable. But with astrophotography comes the need to do auto guiding at some point, especially if you're trying to do any exposures that are several seconds to several minutes long. Depending on your polar alignment, auto-guiding becomes necessary. And so, we have an auto-guider camera. And this is just your regular, very common Starshoot auto-guider from Orion. But this requires two cables. One over here is your USB, and this is your cable for doing the guide pulses. So with that is two additional cables. A USB cable, and an RJ6 cable. Now this RJ6 cable, not nearly as well shielded as the USB 3.0 cable is for the ASI, and this USB 2.0 cable, again, is not quite as well shielded, but we now have two cables that are going from cameras to a laptop somewhere, and these are two sources of drag. There are two sources where the balance can shift on the telescope, and it's two items that can potentially snag and disconnect. Now, to make my life a little easier as an astrophotographer, I've elected to go with an autofocusing system. And so I've got a focus links from Optech. And this focus links requires a serial cable input, which is right there. It also requires a 12 volt power DC in. And it also has a output for the focus. The output for the focus is done with a Cat6 cable, like this. When this gets cold, it becomes stiff, just like my USB cables do, and it's also one additional item that can snag onto a tripod, the mount, something on the ground, and either disconnect or make the slew or the tracking difficult for the telescope. Since we've been talking about cold temperatures and cables getting stiff, I'd also like to show one of the newest things that I've added to my astrophotography collection. That is my dew controller. And this thing is used to help keep dew or frost from forming on the optics of my telescope. And this thing requires three cables for the control of the dew. The first cable is going to control this dew strap here, and the dew strap would go around the objective of the telescope and keep dew or frost from forming on it. The second cable is a temperature probe that fits between the strap and the telescope to monitor the temperature of the OTA. But the third cable is yet a second sensor that monitors the air temperature, and if it's, say, 60 degrees outside, and I want to keep my optics 4 degrees above ambient to keep the dew from forming, this can monitor the fact that it's 60 degrees, and this will monitor the fact that my heat strap is being heated to 64 degrees, and my dew controller can manage the voltage to the heat strap to keep that temperature constant. If the temperature drops by 2 or 3 degrees, the air temperature probe will sense that, and this will send a signal to my dew controller to say, hey, a little less voltage, please. It's we don't need to keep you 8 degrees. We just need to back you down So you're only warming it up by 4 degrees rather. And so that's a power management feature that also keeps this strap from working harder than it needs to. But you have 3 cables, and for the sake of being neat and tidy when I pack things away, I've got it nicely bundled up here. But these would be 3 cables that are attached to the front of the telescope instead of the back. And those 3 cables are things that could, again, snag on the tripod or something on the ground. Now the one common denominator that all of these cables have is they connect into a laptop. And that means that the laptop has to be as close to the telescope as your shortest cable. And unfortunately for me, that would be this cable right here. This cable is about 5 feet long, and that means I have to be within 5 feet of my Focus Link's focus controller, which is Velcroed to a tripod leg. If I had a sufficiently long data cable, I could get away with having this on my the table that my laptop sits on, and I could just run a long data cable to the focuser. But again, that's a longer cable to offset the balance on the back of the telescope as it moves, or to snag on something, and then it becomes my next shortest wire is how close I have to be to my telescope. And that would be probably the data cable for my ASI camera, being that it's 2 meters. The rest of my cables are about 2 meters in length. I believe this is a 10-foot cable, so it's a 3-meter cable for my auto guider. And then, of course, this cable here just goes from the auto guider into the telescope mount itself, and is not really a factor into how close I have to be to the telescope, but it does play a factor into the balance and things on the telescope as it moves around. I don't want a whole lot of this cable swinging around the bottom of the telescope as it moves, changing that center of gravity balance point. And there has to be a better way to manage all of this instead of having it bundled up and just dangling off the back of your telescope as one giant cable bundle. Again, concentrating all of that mass into one area will significantly change the balance point of your scope while it tracks and is attempting to do auto guiding. It's also a larger cable to snag onto something, and should that one of the cables in that bundle snag, the whole bundle begins pulling on the back of the telescope, not just one, and further adds strain to the tracking. So the next video that I'm going to show you is going to begin setting up a foundation for all of this equipment to be much more manageable with in terms of cable management and making sure nothing can offset the balance of your telescope or snag, pull a cable loose, pull a power cord loose, or cause your tracking or guiding to suffer as a result of a snagged cable. Thanks for taking the time today to watch my video. I hope you've learned something new, and I hope you've been inspired to get under the stars and take a look at something through a telescope. If you like what I've been doing, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel. It'll be a great way for you to show your appreciation, and it's the best way to be notified of when new videos get uploaded. Thank you, and clear skies.